In this video, we'll look at two ways to take TDR measurements. First, we'll use a transient simulation to manually run a TDR. Then we'll use the powerful TDR front panel to use S-parameter data to automatically run the measurement. We'll run a TDR measurement on a channel that consists of a connector, a very long lossy transmission line, and finally, another connector. We can run this measurement manually using a step function in a transient simulation. The ratio between V2 and the difference of V1 and V2 will let us calculate the impedance of the reflection. We'll first place a Balun component to convert this common mode set of signals to a differential signal. Now I'll switch to the T-Line's ideal palette and place a coupled line with an even mode operation at 50 ohms, odd mode operation at 50 ohms, and electrical length of 180 degrees at 1 gigahertz. The reason for placing this coupled line will become more apparent after we simulate. Now I'll drop an SMP component from the toolbar. Inside this SMP component, I'll navigate to the file name of the S-parameter file for the connector. Note that if your S-parameter file ports are configured differently, you can change the pin orientation here. I'll now repeat this procedure for both the channel and second connector blocks. Finally, I'll terminate the circuit with a mirrored Balun and resistors to convert back to common mode. We can now simulate this circuit. I'll drop a plot for the impedance. We can now observe the TDR measurement. The coupled line from earlier is responsible for the 1 nanosecond delay. It provides us with a good reference 100 ohm measurement before attempting to measure the TDR. This technique is called port extension. Notice that we can generally see the response from the different parts of the channel. Here we have the connector, the transmission line, and the last connector. It's also important to note that the channel loss is responsible for the apparent increase in the impedance. Now let's explore how to use the TDR front panel to expedite the process of making TDR measurements. The TDR front panel requires an S-parameter dataset to run the TDR measurement. Here's a simple S-parameter simulation setup that represents the exact same channel as our transient simulation. Note that we have the same three SMP components as before, but terminated with TermG components. We'll generate an S-parameter dataset for up to 20 GHz for this channel. Now go to Tools, Front Panel, SPTDR. We'll select the dataset from the S-parameter file. This response will eventually look very similar to the result of the transient simulation. However, there are a few settings we need to change in order to have a plot we can compare to the transient simulation. Let's go to Advanced Settings and then go to Port Mapping. We need to change the ports to differential out and differential in to match the schematic from before. We'll also change the time sweep. Previously, we had set the stop time in the transient simulation to be 20 nanoseconds, so we'll reflect that in this plot. We've now generated the impedance profile under the same conditions as the transient simulation. Notice that the plots from the transient simulation and the TDR front panel are nearly identical. The TDR front panel allows us to rapidly use S-parameter data to run a TDR measurement without having to go through the hassle of setting up a transient simulation. Thank you for watching this Keysight ESOF EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.